فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
أن الإمام الدارقطني رحمه الله سيس حدثنا أحمد بن محمد بن سعيد حدثنا يعقوب بن يوسف بن زياد حدثنا عبيد بن سليمان. The author, what does he say here for you? حدثنا عبيد بن سليمان. Hey, what does your copy say? After that, he says that, right? هذا تصحيف. That's تصحيف. السمين. نعم. There's no يا at the end. السمين. نعم. His name is. That's a تصحيف. And the Sheikh is not right on that. Mm-hmm. نعم. حدثنا معمر بن زائدة عن الأعمش عن إبراهيم عن علقمة عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال جاء حبر إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. So here we have الإمام الدارقطني narrating from who? أحمد بن محمد بن سعيد بن عبد الرحمن بن إبراهيم أبو العباس الكوفي المعروف. He's known as ابن عقدة. كان حافظا عالما مكثرا. He is a person whose narration is large in number. جمع التراجم والأبواب والمشيقة وأكثر الرواية وانتشر حديثه. His narrations are vast in number and he has spread. If you want to see more about him, go to Tariq Baghdad by Imam Khatib al-Baghdadi رحمه الله تعالى. He says he narrated from who? يعقوب بن يوسف بن زياد. His name is يعقوب بن يوسف بن خازم بن زياد بن شريك بن عبد الله أبو يوسف الطحان. His tarjama, his biography is in Tariq Baghdad. وكان ثقة. He was a reliable person. عبيد بن سليمان السمين. He said, حدثنا معمر بن زائدة. معمر بن زائدة. You might wonder and ask yourself, when you were mentioning the five and the extra three, why haven't you mentioned معمر بن زائدة? If you look at Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman رحمه الله at the bottom, what did he say? قال الذهبي معمر بن زائدة عن الأعمش قال العقيلي لا يتابع على حديثه. His narrations, they don't fall under the متابعات. They don't. لا يتابع عليه. Pay attention to that. That's important for you to know. معمر بن زائدة. And that statement, if you want, you can find it in the Kitab Al-Mizan. Written by Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله تعالى. He's the one who transmitted it. ونقله عنه الذهبي في الميزان. As Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghulayman mentions it for you at the bottom. Fourth volume. Page 154. My copy is sixth volume. Page 481. You can go to لسان الميزان also by Imam al-Dhahabi رحمه الله. Ibn Hajar, sorry. لسان الميزان by Imam ibn Hajar. Sixth volume. Page 66. By the way, Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, what he did when he authored his Kitab al-Mizan, Al-Imam ibn Hajar came after him, and what he did is he worked on it. Al-Imam ibn Hajar. So here, his narrations, as it's said by Uqayli, لا يتابع على حديثه. عن الأعمش عن إبراهيم عن علقمة عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه قال, he said, جاء حبر. حبر came. So the man's a scholar. إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ثم ذكر أنه منشد نحوه وقال في آخره. But at the ending he said in his narration, narration of who? معمر بن زائدة عن الأعمش عن إبراهيم عن علقمة. وقال في آخره تعالى عما تشركون وما قدر الله حق قدري والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيميني سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون. Is how we read it. You with me? But here he read it, he said, وَقَالَ فِي آخِرِي تَعَالَ عَمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ قَرَأَهَا الْأَعْمَشْ بِالتَّهِ. أَعْمَشْ, he read it, أَعْمَشْ مِنَ الْقُرَّاءِ, from the Qurra. He read it as تُشْرِكُونَ as a ta instead of a يُشْرِكُونَ as a ya. And he's not the only one who did that, by the way. Hamza does the same, Kisai does the same. وَهُوَ اخْتِيَارُ أَبِي عُبَيْد. And it's also the choice taken by Abu Ubaid that it is read as عَمَّا تُشْرِكُونَ. As for the baqoon of the Qurra, the other remaining Qurra, they read it as عَمَّا يُشْرِكُونَ. Then Dar-Qutni رحمه الله, so he benefited something here from ya. What we benefited عما يشركون, and تشركون can be read. What we also benefited from it is that جاء حبر, a حبر came to the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Also that shows us, brothers, another benefit that we take from this is that if he's a حبر, what does that show us? He read the Torah, he got it from the Torah. And that shows you that they did not distort everything. There were some things in their religion that were still present, that were still there. Also, it shows you that in the previous religions, إثبات الصفات, affirming Allah's characteristics are present in it. We also take it from there. نعم. Now look at it. وَكَذَلِكَ رَوَاهُ عِيسَى بْنُ يُونِسٍ وَقَيْسِ بْنُ الرَّبِيعِ عَنِ الْأَعْمَشِ بِهَذَا الْإِسْنَادِ. So who did it? Yeah, remember we said five. He mentions the other two that I said he didn't mention, right? That he didn't bring a chain for, which is Isa ibn Yunus and Qais ibn al-Rabi'. He just left Abu Muqarrin, he didn't mention him. Na'am. And in A'mashi bihad al-Isnadi, with this chain of narration. Are you with me? Very good. Then the author, rahimahullah, al-Imam al-Daraqutni, he says, حَدَّثَنَا الْقَاضِيُّ الْحُسَيْنِ بْنُ إِسْمَاعِيلِ. So Imam al-Daraqutni narrating from two people. Pay attention here. He says, حَدَّثَنَا الْقَاضِيُّ الْحُسَيْنِ بْنُ إِسْمَاعِيلِ وَمُحَمَّدِ بْنُ إِبْرَاهِيمِ بْنُ حَفْصِ بْنُ شَاهِيمِ. Daraqutni is narrating from two shaykhs, two of his teachers. The first person is narrating from who is? Al-Qadi al-Husayn ibn Ismail. His tarjama we already took. We spoke about him. Muhammad ibn Ibrahim ibn Hafs ibn Shaheen. His tarjama, his biography, you can find it in Tariq al-Baghdad. You can find it in Tariq al-Baghdad. He says, are you with me? Wa Ismail ibn, what's there for you? Ah, that's wrong. Tashif. It's a mistake. It's meant to be Abbas. The author, what does he say? Ayyash is wrong. It's Abbas. Abdullah ibn Muhammad al-Ghunayman is wrong. Naam. وإسماعيل بن عياش الوراق. نعم. So Dar-Qutni narrated from a third person. So he narrated from Al-Qadi Hussein ibn Ismail, وMuhammad ibn Ibrahim ibn Hafs ibn Shaheen, and وإسماعيل ibn عباس الوراق. And also a fourth person, وMuhammad ibn Makhlad وآخرون. That's not only it. More I've narrated from, he said. Are you with me? All of those people, Dar-Qutni are his mashayikh, and they're the people who he has narrated this from. قالوا, all of them they said, حدثنا محمد بن الوليد البصري, حدثنا يحيى بن سعيد القطان, عن سفيان, سفيان هي سفيان الثوري, سفيان هي سفيان الثوري, حدثني منصور, منصور told me, وسليمان, so سفيان الثوري narrated from two people, he narrated from منصور and he narrated from سليمان, عن إبراهيم, عن عبيدة, so where's Al-A'mash's narration gone? A'mash is not in the picture now. So the narrations of A'mash, it finished. He brought his five men that proved that he narrated it from, right? Abu Muawiyah al-Dharir, Muhammad ibn al-Khazimin. We have that. Good. Are you with me? Hafs ibn al-Ghiyath. We have him. Who else? Jarir ibn Abdul Hamid. Who else? Abu Awanat. Abdullah ibn Muhammad, Abdullah Abu Awanata, Abdullah al-Yashkuri. So we have all our five. And we said an extra, Isa ibn Yunus, who he didn't narrate from, and Qais ibn al-Rabi' and Abu Muqarrin, who he never narrated from. He didn't bring it. So those are the five plus three, how much? Eight. He's left now. Sulaiman ibn Mihran is not bringing it anymore. He's not bringing who? He's not bringing Sulaiman ibn Mihran's narrations. Instead, who is he bringing this time? Who is he bringing instead of Sulaiman ibn Mihran? Who did Sulaiman ibn Mihran narrate from? Who did Sulaiman ibn Mihran narrate from? Sulaiman ibn Mihran, Al-A'mash, who did he narrate from? Ibrahim al-Nakha'i. Al-A'mash narrated from Ibrahim al-Nakha'i. Sahih? In this narration, who's the one who's narrated from Ibrahim al-Nakha'i? Those people are who he brought this time. Okay. He's brought the narration of who? Mansur and Sulaiman. They're the ones who took the place of Al-A'mash. Okay. So he says, Al-Imam al-Dharqutni, this narration. He says, حدثنا قاضي الحسين بن إسماعيل ومحمد بن إبراهيم بن حفص بن شاهين وإسماعيل بن عباس الوراق ومحمد بن المخلد محمد بن المخلد وآخرون المني قالوا all of them said حدثنا محمد بن الوليد البصري حدثنا يحيى بن سعيد القطان عن سفيان يعني سفيان الثوري حدثني سفيان الثوري then narrates from who منصور المنصور and سليمان عن إبراهيم يعني إبراهيم النخعي and now إبراهيم is taking Ibrahim is now narrating it instead of from before. Who is he narrating from? Alqamah ibn Qais al-Nakhai, right? Mm-hmm. This time he's narrating it from Abidat al-Salamani, who then narrated from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu, anna yahudiyan ja'a ila an-nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So the first narrated Abu Khari, Imam Dharqutni narrated from who's who? The first person he narrated from is? Yeah, no, here. His name is Al-Qadi Al-Husayn ibn Ismail. Are you with me? Yeah. We've taken him already, his tarjama, when we were talking about hadith number 20, right? Yeah. Muhammad ibn Ibrahim ibn Hafs ibn Shahina, we said his tarjama is Tariq Baghdad, right? Uh-huh. Ismail ibn Al-Abbas Al-Warraq, his tarjama, you can find it in Sir Alam al-Nubala, the 15th volume, page 74. And he said about him, Al-Imam Muddal al-Dhahabi said about him, Al-Muhaddith, Al-Imam Al-Hujjah, Abu Ali Ismail ibn Al-Abbas ibn Umar ibn Mihran Al-Baghdadi Al-Warraq. Muhammad ibn Makhlad, we spoke about him already in the second hadith. Muhammad ibn al-Walid ibn Abdul Hamid, Abu Abdullah al-Qurashi, thiqqat min rijali tahdib. This narration, if you want, you can find it in Al-Imam al-Dharqutni's kitab, Ilal al-Warida, 5th volume, page 179. And look at the takhrij of Imam al-Dharqutni, he goes into detail, so there's no need for me to go into the chain of narration here. Sufyan here is Sufyan al-Thawri, as I said to you. عن منصور وسليمان. We're going to take all of those inshallah ta'ala as the narrations come. عن إبراهيم عن أبيدة عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه أن يهوديا جاء إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. A Jew came to the Prophet. فقال يا محمد he said يا محمد إن الله عز وجل يمسك السماوات على أصبع والشجر على أصبع والخلائق على أصبع ثم يقول أنا الملك فضحك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى بدت نواجذه ثم قال وما قدر الله حق قدري والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون أو تشركون صح؟ قال يحيى هوز يحيى هي؟ يحيى بن سعيد القطان وزاد فيه فضيل بن عياض added an extra thing onto this بهذا الإسناد with this chain of narration فضحك رسول الله the prophet laughed تعجبا وتصديقا له here it is for you تعجبا when the prophet laughed and his molar teeth showed it was out of amazement and it was in agreement. So what are we using as a proof that Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala has a finger here? Takriru Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, not the Jew statement. You know, there's those people criticize Kitab al-Tawheed. Wallahi they do. And what do you know what they say? Kitab al-Tawheed, there's narrations of the Jews from it. And they bring this kind of narration and say, look, your book is about Jews and narrated from Jews. Sahih? We're taking that the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in agreement with him, the takrir and the consent of the Prophet alayhi salatu, والسلام. That's what we're taking as a proof. And that's what we are using as a proof. Did I read it correctly? It's there, right? Yeah. But it's not Fudail. Ha, قال يحيى بن سعيد قال يحيى بن سعيد القطان يعني وزاد في فضيل بن عياض عن منصور عن إبراهيم عن عبيدة عن عبد الله رضي الله تعالى عنه قال فضحك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تعجبا وتصديقا صح؟ yeah. نعم. I actually read the second. I read the hadith to come after. That's what I was reading. الممر الدارقطني says حدثنا أحمد بن محمد أبو بكر الواسطي. Who is this أحمد بن محمد بن أبي بكر الواسطي؟ He is ابن باغندي. الإمام الخطيب البغدادي brings in his تاريخ بغداد. His kunya is أبو ذر الأزدي. And he's well known as باغندي. وهو ثقة لا يقبل كلامه في أبيه ولا كلام أبيه فيه. His father criticized him and he criticized his father. Both of their narrations is not taken regarding one another. Meaning is they considered it to be كلام الأقران يطوى ولا يروى. نعم. He says وأحمد so دار القطني narrated from who? أحمد بن محمد بن أبي بكر الواسطي. And he also narrated from who? وأحمد بن عبد الله بن محمد الوكيل ومحمد بن سهل بن الفضيل الكاتب. He narrated from how many people? Three people. قالوا all of them said حدثنا عمر بن شبة. عمر بن شبة من رجال التهذيب. من رجال محمد بن سهل بن الفضيل. We already spoke about him. As for this أحمد ابن عبد الله ابن محمد الوكيل. He is أحمد ابن عبد الله ابن محمد أبو بكر النحاس, who is very well known as بوكيل أبي سخرة. He's ترجمة. You can find it تاريخ بغداد. قالوا حدثنا عمر بن شبة حدثنا يحيى بن سعيد القطان حدثنا سفيان يعني سفيان الثوري حدثني منصور. منصور told me. منصور told me. وسليمان عن سليمان عن إبراهيم النخعي عن عبيدة السلماني عن عبد الله بن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنهم أن يهوديا أي جومان جاء إلى النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كيف ترفف فقال يا محمد إن الله عز وجل يمسك السماوات على أصبع والشجر على أصبع والخلائق على أصبع ثم يقول أنا الملك فضحك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حتى بدت نواجذه ثم قال وما قدر الله حق قدري والأرض جميعا قبضته يوم القيامة والسماوات مطويات بيمينه سبحانه وتعالى عما يشركون وعما تشركون. قال يحيى بن سعيد القطان وزاد فيه فضيل بن عياض بهذا الإسناد فضحك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم تعجبا وتصديقا له. This hadith Bukhari narrated it, Tirmidhi narrated it, Nasa'i narrated it, Ahmad narrated it, Ibn Khuzayman narrated it, Ibn Abi Asim narrated it, Abdullah ibn Ahmad narrated it, Tabarani narrated it, Ibn Battah narrated it, Abu Shaykh narrated it. Also the Musannif himself, Ad-Darqutni brought it in his Ilal. All of them, what tariqa? All of those are mentioned. They all narrated it من طريق يحيى بن سعيد القطان عن سفيان الثوري عن منصور وسليمان. Are you there? Are you there? عن إبراهيم عن عبيدة عن ابن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه. By the way, who's this Suleiman? Just so you guys don't confuse it with anyone. Who's this? Mansur we know. Like Mansur we understand. We took him before. Who is Suleiman? Suleiman ibn Mihran al-A'mash. It's A'mash, نعم. It's A'mash. نعم. عن إبراهيم عن عبيدة عن ابن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه. There's a couple of mistakes. There's a point that needs to be mentioned that Al-Imam, mashallah, Ibn Khuzaymah mentioned in the Kitab al-Tawheed, which is that Al-Imam al-Hafidh Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan did a mistake. And by the way, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, he is of the caliber of Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. His knowledge of hadith and his caliber, his memories, mashallah. Ala hadha al-tabaqat, some of the ulama of hadith, they put him to that level. And Yahya ibn Ma'in and Ishaq ibn Rahuya and the likes of them at that level. الإمام ابن خزيمة critiqued him on a particular point. He says الجواد قد يعثر في بعض الأوقات. The person who's mashallah, who's high knowledgeable and his understanding is very great, times that he does a mistake. So here, slip of a tongue, mistakes do happen from him. He said وهيم يحيى بن سعيد القطان. يحيى بن سعيد القطان did a mistake. في إسناد خبر الأعمش, in the chain of narration of سليمان بن مهران الأعمش. مع حفظه وإتقانه. Even though he's a حافظ. يحيى بن سعيد القطان. And he's itqan, brothers pay attention. Mutqin, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan was mutqin. Like little mistakes you could pick up. وعلمي بالأخبار, and his knowledge of the narrations. فقال, he said, عن عبيدة عن عبد الله. Are you with me? He said, عن عبيدة عن عبد الله بن مسعود. Are you with me? وإنما هو عن علقمة. Are you with me? Pay attention. This is who the statement of who? Ibn Khuzaymah. We're going to judge between the two of them. Who's right? Ibn Khuzaymah, Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan. But first of all, listen to what Ibn Khuzaymah is saying. He's وَإِنَّمَا هُوَ عَنْ عَلْقَمَةً. He says, عَبِيدَةَ السَّلَمَانِيُّ did not narrate directly from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Between عَبِيدَةَ السَّلَمَانِي and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is عَلْقَمَةَ ibn Qays al-Nakhai. Pay attention. وَأَمَّا خَبَرُ مَنْصُورٍ. As for the khabar of Mansur, فَهُوَ عَنْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَنْ عَبِيدَةَ عَنْ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ. The chain of Mansur is from who? Ibrahim. And then narrates from عَبِيدَةَ عَنْ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ ibn Mas'ud. وَالْإِسْنَادَانِ ثَابِتَانِ صَحِيحَانِ. And both of the chains of narrations are correct and authentic. Mansur, عَنْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ عَنْ عَبِيدَةَ عَنْ عَبْدِ اللَّهِ. As for A'mash's narration is, A'mash, عَنْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ عن علقمة عن عبد الله. Pay attention. Does that make sense? So the chain of Mansur and Sulaiman are not the same. Whereas Mansur's chain is Abida directly from Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. Like in the Sanad of Sulaiman ibn Mihran al-A'mash, between Abdullah ibn Abida al-Salamani and Abdullah ibn Mas'ud, in between them is علقمة ibn Qays al-Nakhai. Pay attention. That's what Ibn Khuzaymah is saying. Mansur عن إبراهيم عن عبيدة عن عبد الله والأعمش عن إبراهيم عن علقمة عن عبد الله غير مستنكر لإبراهيم النخعي علمي وطول مجالسة أصحابه ابن مسعود أن يروي خبرا عن جماعة من أصحاب ابن مسعود. ابن حجر didn't accept that. ابن حجر العسقلاني in فتح الباري, are you with me? He didn't accept that. Are you there? Al-Imam Hafiz ibn Hajar, Imam Amir al-Mu'mineen fi al-Hadith. He looked at the matter, observed what Ibn Khuzaymah said, and what he critiqued for Yahya ibn Sa'id al-Qattan, Al-Imam al-Hafiz al-Mutqin. So what he did was, Hafiz says, وَتَصَرُّفُ الشَّيْخَيْنِ. He's talking about the صَرُّفُ الشَّيْخَيْنِ Bukhari and Muslim. The doings of Bukhari and Muslim. يَقْتَرِي أَنَّهُ عِنْدَ الْأَعْمَشْ عَلَى وَجْهَيْنِ. That A'mash has two ways that he narrated it. وأما ابن خزيمة فقال, as for ابن خزيمة, he has said, فهو رواية الأعمش. He's referring to the أعمش is ابن خزيمة's statement is from the رواية of أعمش that in between is علقمة ابن قيس. صح؟ That he says رواية الأعمش is what? عبيدة السلام إبراهيم النخعي عن علقمة عن أبيدة عن علقمة. رواية المسعود is what? وهما صحيحان. So Imam Ibn Hajar, he says both of the narrations narrating from Abid Salmani, Sulaiman ibn al-Mihran, once narrating like this and once having علقمة in there, both of them are صحيح. There's no تناقض and there's nothing there. And also that opinion is what Dara Qutni chose and liked. That's what he did here right now, صح? And that's what he does in his Kitab Al-Ilal Al-Warida. That this is nothing wrong with it.